Stress is a significant contributor to illnesses. One person out of three reports feeling very stressed in their daily life, which tends to put us at risk of activating harmful viruses that may be in our system. When we experience stress, we harm our body's ability to fight antigens with antibodies. Daily stress and stressful situations can be very detrimental to our immune system. They have found ways to change their perspective to be less reactive about various situations that may arise. The more stress reduction activities you can bring in your life, the stronger your immune system will become. If you are interested in doing so, here are a few suggestions to consider. Adopt a positive attitude. According to studies across the world, positivism is a trait that increases your health and reduces your chances of being sick from a virus. Not only is the immune system of optimistic people more robust, but they also show signs of being healthier in general. Whatever happens around you, you always have a choice of how you respond to that situation. You either see it with half-full glass or half-empty glass. An excellent way to start improving your attitude is to focus on gratitude. Finding things that you are grateful for will help you see the best in everything. You can do so by writing in a journal the daily gratitude that you want to express. Practice mindfulness to manage your tensions. You can adopt a new perspective on life by adding a mindfulness practice. Mindfulness is the ability to stay in the present moment and stop worrying about the past or the future. Less mental stress also means less physical stress and give more power to your immune system. During the 21-day plan, you will have a whole week dedicated to managing your stress. You will learn concrete activities or exercises you can add to your day to help you feel calmer. Based on recent research, exercising can be beneficial to the immune system as we age. According to studies, daily activity can strengthen the immune system across the lifespan. Another interesting finding is that not only does frequent exercise boost our immunity, it also seems to delay its aging, allowing us to maintain an optimal immune system as we grow older. Daily exercise can be as simple as a 20 to 30 minute walk. You can also add yoga or Pilates to your routine. Stretch for relaxation. Since the body immunity respond better when the body is relaxed, as mentioned in the previous chapter, it is only logical to help the body relax with stretches. Stretches like the forward fold can boost the immune system by bringing blood flow into your sinuses and release its congestion. Stretches can be done in the morning and in the evening. You only need a few minutes of stretches for your body to benefit. Yoga for the immune system. Yoga is not only a great way to move the body, but it also has some known benefits to our immunity. Try the cobra pose for 3 deep breaths to stimulate the thymus for the growth of T cells. The legs up the wall position can also help the body relax by encouraging blood circulation, lymph drainage, see the lymphatic system in chapter 1, and relax and reset the nervous system. Detoxifying the body while exercising can help the body rid itself of toxins. Drinking plenty of fluids will also help your body flush the toxins like bacteria that could cause sickness. Water is essential in the process of detoxification. 75% of people are dehydrated consistently, and that's probably one of the main reasons why most of us get sick or don't recover fast from illnesses. Water is critical to flush any toxins from our body. If we don't have enough water, we can't get rid of the toxins fast enough. Toxins can be in the form of viruses or bacteria. Drinking plenty of water can fight off infection. You can start increasing your water consumption by always having a bottle with you that you can refill. It is recommended to get around 2 to 3 liters of water per day. While moving the body is beneficial, drinking water and staying hydrated can have a significant impact on your immune system. Sleep and renewing the body. Sleeping is, by far, one of the best remedies to help the immune system fight off any disruptive bug in your body. Sleep is crucial for the body's production of cytokines. Cytokine is a protein that reduces inflammation and infection in the body. Sleep is critical to ensure a healthy immune system that is always ready to fight any bacteria and viruses. The recommended sleep hours are 7 to 9 hours per night to rest and regenerate the body adequately. If some days you are unable to get the recommended dose of sleep, try to do 1 or 2 naps of 30 minutes during the day. If you don't get enough sleep, your immune system can't function optimally. Here are a few ideas to help you improve your sleep. Create a routine. It is proven that a routine will trick your body into falling asleep at a specific time. Try to observe yourself. Is there a time when you are tired? If so, make sure you go to bed before that time. Create a routine that allows you to complete everything before that time and go to bed. You can also set an alarm that will tell you that it's time to prepare yourself for bedtime. That way, you are less likely to forget what time it is and be more successful at implementing a routine. A bedtime ritual is an excellent addition to your schedule. A good bedtime ritual is one that allows you to relax, disconnect from the stress of life, and slowly tell your body that it is time to shut down. Set a comfortable atmosphere. It might be time to look at your bedroom and try to find ways to improve the atmosphere for a good night's sleep. Don't underestimate the comfort of your bed and pillow and the power of fresh linen. If you are uncomfortable, you will likely have a hard time falling asleep or staying asleep. Another aspect of comfort is the temperature of the room and the level of noise around. Try sleeping with a fan on or a white noise machine. Having a constant sound in the room could help you maintain your sleep. If you like essential oils, try a drop of lavender on your pillow. This will help the brain relax. Are there electronics that make it bright at night, like the light on a laptop charger or your alarm clock? Make sure that you can remove the light and make the space dark for sleep. Also, consider moving the TV in your bedroom. The TV will stimulate you instead of encouraging sleep. Reducing the use of devices will probably be the most challenging thing to do, but the most effective, which is to turn off any electronics 1 hour before bedtime. Spend the last hour doing something calming and relaxing. Avoid any alcohol, cigarettes, caffeine, or a large meal from 2 to 3 hours before you go to bed. Talk to an expert if you've tried all those recommendations and you are still struggling with sleep. It might be a good idea to consult your doctor or a sleep expert.